Welcome back to Design Bundles YouTube channel. If you guys are new here, my name is Crystal, and today I have a super fun summer project for you. We are going to be decorating one of these little trays here. You can get two-tier, three-tier, so on and so forth. There's been birthdays, all sorts of fun stuff. So this is just one of many. So today we're doing this super fun summer theme, like I said. The file that I'm using today is also linked down below, as well as all of the supplies that I'm using today. So I'm actually going to take you guys over to designbundles.net so I can show you what file we're using. And then I'm also going to go ahead and show you over on Glowforge how I got the best out of my wood to be able to add all of these pieces in. And then we're going to paint them really quick and put it together. So let's go ahead and dive right in. All right, so starting off over here on designbundles.net, this is the file that I'm using today. It is so, so cute. So you guys can kind of see here on a two-tiered what this is going to look like. Now, you guys can add in extras. I didn't do that today just to show you if you only use these pieces, but you could definitely get some beads in here. You can bring in some little ceramic pieces, coffee mugs, whatever you want to do to really make it extra. But as you can see, there is a variety of pieces here. And if you click through here, there is a few different photos that shows you all of the pieces that you guys are going to be able to cut out and then gives you an idea of how to paint them. You could definitely paint this in whatever color scheme that you want to. So like I said, this is down below. So let's go ahead and head on over to Glowforge. All right, so now that we're over here in Glowforge, this is their Create software. I've already uploaded. What I brought in was the SVG file. You can do that by clicking on this plus right here and then clicking on upload. So I brought in the SVG version. So you're going to notice over here on the left side, we have some engrave, we have some cut as well as cut. And we are going to be cutting all those. Now, the ones that say the engrave, I'm actually going to go ahead and ignore those. Those are those numbers. So I'm not going to use those myself. So we're going to actually go and start with these cut files and start moving them in. So what I did was I just brought them in. You can bring them in multiple by selecting them like this and then just bring them and move them in. Now, don't feel like you have to keep those in a row. So if I can do this and rotate them and get them to fit better like this, you can definitely feel free to do that. Now, what's really cool about this is we already have these size for you. So you don't even need to resize or anything. These things, unless you want them bigger or smaller, obviously, but they are perfectly sized for a tiered tray. So you can just move these in so that way you can get the most bang for your buck with your wood, right? So you're just going to go ahead and do all this. Now, I can go ahead and hit delete on all of these numbers here and get rid of them. Or you can click on that layer right over here and just click on, I was going to say delete, but I guess we can't do it like so. You can also hit the back button here just to kind of zoom out and get rid of some more of those numbers. So if I wanted to scroll down and kind of delete some more of those numbers, I could do so. Now, with these pieces here, we're going to go ahead and continue to bring these up here. All right, so now what I want to show you is the difference between what layers need to be scored and what layers need to be cut. So for example, to see the difference in the layer, so you if you click on this one, you're going to see that layer highlight. And then if you click on the other layer, you're going to see all those pieces highlight. So I know this is my cut layer because individual pieces like this are lining up too. So you can even see the outside of this square that's going to cut. Now the inside pieces that now you see glowing in purple there, those are going to score. So if they're set at a cut and they're red as well, we want to actually set those to score. So we are going to have score lines. So whenever we cut these pieces out over here in particular, those little letters are going to line right up. Now for me, I sometimes use it and sometimes don't. So if you just want to go ahead and line these up by yourself and you don't want those score lines, you don't have to use them. You can just simply go over here and hit ignore and it's not going to score anything. So it's going to cut everything out and it's not going to score a thing. But if you want those score lines, so that way it just makes it a whole lot easier to line up, you can definitely do so. But for today's project, I did not use them. But for another one that's coming up soon, we'll be doing a live on, or we've already done a live on, I actually did do the score lines on those. So you can definitely reference to that video. So that's it. All you're just going to continue to do is line everything up like so. Remember, you want to score first and then cut. So it would be score, engrave, cut. And that's how you would want your layer. So if we had any sort of engrave, we'd have score, engrave, and then cut. So for example, if my score was underneath my cut, I would just simply grab it and bring it up. Now, like I said, all I'm doing is I can come out here and I can actually see I've got a ton more pieces. I can grab multiple of them. And I'm just going to get as many of these in here as I can. And once again, I'm going to nestle these in together. So I'll kind of bring this guy in. I can rotate it and really get in there. So don't feel like you just have to put these the way they are. You can actually rotate them and get them exactly where you want them to be. So super duper easy. Now, I do believe it took me 2 sheets completely to do all this. So if you kind of go around here, you can see all these. What I like to do is drag everything and go up to the top. So I'll kind of get a hold of it and drag it over here to the top right-hand side, just so I'm not having to continue to dig for it. So if we go down here, we can see that we're at number 7. This is our last 2 pieces here. You can always go to the right just to make sure we didn't miss anything there. But that's it. So you're just going to keep on loading those. And then once you're done, you're going to go ahead and hit that print button and send it over to the Glowforge. All right, so let's get ready to put these things together. All right, so now that I've walked you through all of that, we're going to go ahead and put this thing together. So going over the supplies, I use 1/8 MDF. I have that link down below for you guys. And then I am using the StarCraft chalk paint today. Use whatever brand you prefer, whatever you like. If you like acrylic, if you want to spray paint these things, whatever you want to do. So for me, I'm going to use the chalk paint. But like I said, something like this. So this is going to be the background here that we're going to paint, I believe, solid white. You could do a pattern vinyl with this if you wanted to. So feel free to think outside of the box. Now, I wanted to go ahead and give you a few tips and tricks here. You could take a cookie sheet whenever you guys are working on these projects. So for example, I like to pre-cut a bunch of stuff out because obviously I'm teaching things. What I have found, I'm going to have a link down below for y'all, is a We Are Memory Keepers cart. So these almost are like a little serving tray, if you will. And I think it comes with 5 or 6 layers and they just slide on there. And so what I do is I put a piece of parchment down. This is just to keep it clean from any sort of, you know, burnt wood or anything over time. And so I've got that down and then I layer them in. Then if I have another layer, I need to separate pieces. I'll put it on top here and then I'll put extra pieces there. So that's a little tip for me. And then you can layer those. So that way, whenever you're ready to go make that project, you can go make it. Or if you have a small business, you can pre-cut tons of those and have them ready to get out and go ship. So that's just a little tip for me in case you guys have a Glowforge and you guys are looking for some fun tips today. Another one is using a Cricut mat or a sticky mat of some sort, doesn't matter the brand, to help hold down those small intricate pieces to paint them. Now, you could also leave, so whenever it cuts out in that piece of wood, you can actually cover that with, before you pull it off, you can cover it with a piece of like something that's a delicate tape, like a painter's tape or something, cover it, then lift it up so they stay in there, set it down on your surface, peel that back, paint it, and then you can do the same, you know, so that way you can paint all those pieces together and don't have to worry about them being all over. But you could definitely just put them down on a little mat like this. They're going to hold in place while we paint them. And you guys will see that here in a second. Now, another thing I like to do with that is I organize. So I've got my white. So all these pieces are going to be painted white. All of these pieces are going to be painted in an orange, green, blue, etc. So that way I'm working in areas. So I already organize. Then we'll do the same thing with my bigger pieces here in a second, which you guys are going to see. I'll organize them by color so I can paint all those at one time. For my glue, I am using Gorilla Wood Glue. It's my favorite. And then I've got a few paint brushes and foam brushes here. So I'm going to go ahead and drop the camera here so we can start painting. All right, so we are ready to go. So what we want to do is organize our pieces that are going to be by color pieces. So for example, this right here is actually going to be painted white. And then this part of the glasses is going to be painted blue. So I'm going to make my different piles here. So this part of the flower is going to be white. These pieces of the flower are going to be this orange. And it's actually more of like that yellow, if you will. So I'm going to go ahead and set those aside. We've got our blue here. I'm actually going to scoot our blue here. And then our wood frame here is also going to be the same yellow orangish, if you will. So I love it because it creates that frame for us too, for this little you know, this little background layer right here. This layer is also white. Now, the one thing is I really should have scored this piece at least because it was going to put some lines down it for us and look like it was, why do I want to say burlap? It's not burlap, but you know what I'm talking about? The little pieces of wood that go that little farmhouse look. And then this piece right here is going to be blue. And then these pieces right here are also going to be white. So I'm going to go ahead and get these little guys over here. Which honestly, I could even get these little guys up here for the white and get them down here with my little white section. And then I've also got another blue, another white. This guy's going to be orange. I don't think I have an orange layer just yet. This guy's going to be orange. And then I do believe that this guy's going to be white. And then all of these guys are going to be orange as well. All right. So I'm going to go ahead and scoop this guy out of my way just a little bit. I'll probably bring in this little parchment paper to paint on as well. So let's go ahead and start with our little bitty pieces first. So like I said, I've organized them in separate areas. And then we're going to go ahead and just start with each of these. I'm going to go ahead. You just want to shake your paint up just a little bit. I'll get these back here. And then I'm going to take a little foam brush. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and dip right into this white here. And we can go ahead and just kind of dab that on there. So I'm not pushing on them because I don't want them to kind of shove around on the mat. Because what I'm doing here is I'm not using a fresh mat. Now, you can if you want to. Say, for example, I only really use a Glowforge. I'm purchasing a sticky mat from the store specifically to use for this. Go for it. But for me, what I do is I use the ones that are a little bit less sticky that have had a lot of life to them. And instead of tossing them out, now I'm using them for my Glowforge. So this may not be a new tip to somebody, but I definitely, I'm not sure if anybody else is doing it. I'm sure it is. I'm just now getting into Glowforge. But today I was thinking to myself and I thought, how am I going to, what's going to be the best way to paint these little pieces? Because if not, I'm going to have to hold them with tweezers or something. So I think this is our best bet. All right. So what I'm doing here now is I'm just going to go ahead and line up these pieces out here so we can get ready to paint them. So I'm going to scoot this guy over. So what I'm doing while I have my brush, I'm doing all the same color first. So it just makes it easier. Makes sense. Work smarter, not harder. Is that what they say? And then we've got all those pieces over there. Those are orange. So all these pieces here should be white. So I'm going to go ahead and do all of these at the same time. All right. Now, what I love about chalk paint, I've talked about it. If you guys have watched me live or you guys have watched any of our tutorials here, I love chalk paint because it dries super duper fast. Now, this is MDF, so it does have a tendency of really soaking up the color. So depending on the look that you want, if you want it to look a little bit more, you know, rustic and washed out, you can definitely keep it at the one. Most of the time, I've gotten away with the one layer. I haven't really had to go in with two. So for messing with this MDF, it's working out pretty good. But feel free, like I said, to use whatever chalk paint. I know there's lots of them out there and whatever is your favorite. But so far, this one is mine. I really hope StarCraft is going to come out with more colors soon. I definitely play around and kind of mix my own and create what you guys are going to see here. I'll make that lighter yellow color with that orange and some white here in a second. But I definitely do hope sooner than later they're going to be coming out with some more colors. All right, so we're just going to quickly go through here and get all of these here. And I don't have to, if you're selling these, you may want to be mindful about your back and not get paint all over the place. Or you may also need to, so I'm not painting the back of mine, but you may want to paint the back of yours because if it's something that you're selling or gifting to somebody, you may want to have those painted, especially if you can see it from the backside, the way that you're going to have it on your table, you can see from both sides. You may want to finish it out and do both sides. Now, for me, I'm not going to do that. We're going to save time since I'm trying to go through this little thing here just to show y'all. Now, I do want to go ahead and mention my aunt is actually going on a cruise, and she had been asking me to make her something to stick on her door. Apparently, it is a thing. If you guys have went on a cruise and you know what I'm talking about, definitely drop it down below, is to put magnets or decorate your doors. So she'd been asking me to come up with something to decorate her door. And I talked about this, I was making this tray and she's like, oh my gosh, it's summer theme. Can I have it? And I was like, yeah, you could actually stick magnets. So she's going to take this on a cruise with her and she's going to glue heavy magnets. So this is another idea. You don't have to use this project for this tiered tray. You could use these for magnets for your fridge. So you could do whatever you want to. But, or sell them in your, you know, individually as individual designs like this for magnets in your boutique or whatever it may be or online. So she's going to take these on the cruise for us and she's going to send back some photos. So we'll keep an eye out on our Instagram and hopefully you guys can see that pretty soon. So she's going to probably within the next few months, she is going to take some pictures, like I said, to show us how it looks on our door. So she's got some nice heavy magnets that she's going to glue on the back of these. All right, so there's our white. So I'm going to go ahead and move on to the next color. Now, at some point, I'm probably going to go ahead and speed this up just because it's going to be repetitive now, just going through the colors. So I'm going to go ahead and scoot this guy out of the way and get ready for the next color. All right, so we're going to go ahead and jump right into this fun. This is actually a coral, but it's a nice as for an orange. So we're just going to clean off any excess. And then, like I said, just kind of dab it along. If you're able to kind of hold down, you can kind of swipe there a little bit, but mostly just wiping off a lot of that excess paint and dabbing works like a charm. So now, because my mat is lost some of its stick, some of those pieces may try to move on us, and I'll get those popped back down in a second. But like I said, I really love this color here, this coral. It's really pretty for an orange. So I'm just going to tap, tap, tap. Down there. All right, nice scene. Okay, I think that was pretty much our pieces that had moved on us. Now, all of this down here, I know this part of my mat is not super duper sticky. So we're going to go ahead and just keep going through here. So I'm going to go ahead and get the rest of these small pieces, and then I'll bring in those big ones. So like I said, I'm going to go ahead and speed it up. All right, so what you guys see me doing now is, remember, I'm going to mix some of this coral with that white to create somewhat of that yellow look. So we're just going to see what it creates mixing the two, what lighter color it gives us. Basically, we just want a lighter, this is more, obviously, I'm not good with my color. You guys already know the drill on this, but basically we want it lighter than that. So I'm going to go ahead and I think that should be good enough for us to kind of get it to pop separately. Or what I may actually do is just come back in with a yellow. I'm trying to decide, maybe I'll just put a little bit of yellow in there and get that to become the color that we want it to be. So now that's about where I want it to be. All right, so I just mixed in a little bit of some acrylic paint. I just mixed in some bright yellow. So what I'm doing here, since I've already got this, I'm just using that same orange brush, and then I'm going to come in and paint the these frame pieces here, all right? All over the pieces that need to be this orangish yellow color. There we go. So feel free, like I said, just to kind of play around with your colors. I mean, if you don't have, I mean, I'm not the best at picking out, you know, which pieces go together from the little color wheel, but if you play around with it long enough, you're going to get the color that you want, or you don't want, if you will. But we're just going to go ahead and continue to paint all these pieces. Now, I don't have a whole lot, as you guys can see here, for this color, so it's not going to take me no time at all. I really just have a few pieces here. So we've got this one here. We've got one more. And then I've got those little pieces of that flower. And then we'll come back and get those little pieces for this. And once again, there's not very many for that. So I'm going to go ahead and speed it back up. All right, so now we're dipping into this mint color from StarCraft. Gosh, it's gorgeous. And so what I'm going to do here is I accidentally colored Summer, which I was supposed to do in green. But once again, you can definitely feel free to do whatever you want. Do whatever color scheme you want. But I'm just going to pounce right on top of this color because it's already dried on us. That's how fast this chalk paint is I'm already from the orange to the colors I've done. This layer right here is already done. So see, I was able to just go right back on top of that. And then now I'm going to go ahead and get all of my little tree pieces here. It really helps when it's on a sticky part of the mat, and it may very well be that, say, for example, if your mats are not, you may want to start out with a new mat, but I definitely just think it's perfect to use for those mats that are just, you know, maybe just not pretty enough. I mean, they may have a tiny bit of stick left, but definitely love finding uses for things like this. Such a breeze. Love it. All right. So I've got those down. I know it looks similar to the white, but it is not. It is green on camera. So hopefully you guys are able to pick that up. I think you guys are actually able to pick it up. All right. So there we have it. Now the next color, we're going to go into our very last one here, and I'm just going to go with a one coat. I think it's going to be completely fine. And then we are going to get our last one here, which is going to be this blue. So I'm going to go ahead and go in here, and I'm using this turquoise here. And I'm almost on the fence about mixing it with some white to make it a little bit lighter. All right, so we're moving right along into our blue pieces. So I'm going to go ahead and get some of this. This is a turquoise, but I think it's going to be super nice for the blue, if you will. So I'm going to go ahead and just tap these little bitty pieces. Oop, these little bitty pieces belong on our life raft. These pieces are definitely not in a sticky area. I'm going to probably just go ahead and quickly pounce that. Now with the chalk paint, it's so easy to get off your hands. If you're in your craft space and you keep baby wipes, you can definitely just use a baby wipe. Or once you're done, head on over to the sink. It's going to wipe right off. So like I said, absolutely love chalk paint. If you guys have not used it before, I think you guys will be fans after this. All right, so there we have it. So I've got those pieces. So now we've got a few big pieces left for our blue. So I'm going to grab one more piece of parchment. All right, so we're going to bring in our last pieces of that we're going to be painting blue here. We've got all these little fun pieces right here. I'm going to scoot this up so hopefully you guys can still see everything. There we go. All right, so we're just going to quickly, I'm going to fast forward through this, and we'll paint all these pieces this turquoise. All right, there we have it. So I'm going to go ahead and let all of these pieces dry down really quickly, and then we'll start putting them together. All right, so we are ready to start assembling, so let's get going. So we're going to be using some glue, this Gorilla Glue. So I'm going to go ahead and just double check it and make sure everything's ready to go on it. So you can do a couple variety of things when it comes time to putting your pieces down, is you can just simply glide your, you know, glue over the back carefully like this, or you could use a little fine paintbrush to move all those pieces around as well. But I'm just carefully, I'm not really squeezing on it. I'm letting what glue can touch it, it stick to it. So you just want to do that all the way across. So I'm going to go ahead and start with my big word here. And I can tell, I'm going to flip this around. You can tell where this is going to go because it's going to, has almost like an offset for that S and that end of that R there. Now, any adhesive you're going to see is going to dry down clear. So I'm just going to kind of hold that for just a second. You can already see this 3D piece start to come together. It is so cool and a ton of fun. So I'm going to go ahead and get this piece here. So this is the sunglasses. Now it did show behind these sunglasses like little touches of white. So what you can do afterwards is you can come in here and with a paintbrush, a fine one, and go in between those the glasses there to adjust that behind it so it's white. There we go. Get our sunglasses in there, our little sunnies. And then we are going to go ahead and get our little bitty birds. This stuff's going to go along super quick, so it's not going to take no time at all. So I've got a little adhesive here, and I'm just going to use that to dab in here to get my birds on. So we'll go ahead and get the little one here. And then we'll go ahead and get that bigger one. Right here. There we go. And then we're going to go ahead and get is here. So we're going to go ahead and line these up. So what I'm going to do before I start adding adhesive here is with pieces like this, since I don't have the score lines, I got rid of those, save some time. So I'm going to go ahead and just line everything up where I want it to be. Something about this looks good to me. And then once I'm happy with it, I'll go ahead and go pick up one letter at a time, get a little bit of adhesive here. Get it down and then truck all the way across. Now, another thing that you can do is once you get them, you could take a piece of tape like I talked about before, take a piece of painter's tape and stick it across these. You could take a, you know, couple pieces of washi tape and then you can just go right across the top of that, pick it up, get adhesive, get it down. And once it dries, you can come back and peel that washi or painter's tape back off. All right, so I'm going to go and bring our very first one up here. So like I said, you guys can see that adhesive right now. The glue back there is going to dry down clear. I'm going to try to tilt this. I don't think anything's going to fall right now. So you guys can hopefully see that 3D effect going on there. I love it. It came out so, so cute. So we're going to go ahead and set our very first piece aside and come into the next one. All right, so let's figure out which pieces we want to do next. Let's go ahead and do, I think we can go ahead and move into this one here. So let's get the little sunglasses. I'll start with the trees. Well, let's start with the sunglasses first. So you'd want to go ahead and get your sunglasses down. So I'm going to go ahead and do the same thing. Just go over. When it's bigger pieces like this, not so tiny like the letters, it does make it pretty easy to go over the back. So hopefully you guys can see that adhesive there. It's not, this is a lot easier to go. I'm not squeezing. I'm just letting it kind of go out on its own. And then we're just going to line this guy up. Once again, it kind of has its own little offset going on there. So we're going to go ahead and get that down, and then we'll start bringing in our trees. I'm going to start with these ones here. So hopefully you can see that's going to pop in there. So, so cute. And you never want to go down on that side. You always want to go down on the back side of these pieces here. And I'm going to go ahead and get some down on the trees. There you go. So if you know somebody that likes to decorate these little tiered trays, this is going to make a perfect gift for anybody. They are a ton of fun. You can store these in those little clear Tupperware totes to change them out throughout the season, like I talked about. So I do believe I'm going to go ahead and double check. You can bring in all your pieces just to double check you have everything where it's supposed to be. Just like that. All right. So I do believe I am missing. I'm not sure how I lost that. But I have lost my little bitty piece right here. But what I can actually do, because it is this blue, try to see if that's enough blue to come in. I'm just going to paint that guy. I lost this. This should have been a 3D piece there. And somehow I lost it. So I'm just going to paint that board myself. That little background piece. But I obviously dropped that somewhere. I'll find it as soon as I'm done with this. I know I will. So I'm going to go ahead and just do this back layer. So if you guys want to leave out pieces like this, so it's not necessarily, this one's a 3D piece. I just filled it in on my own. All right. So I've adjusted that just a little bit. I may come back in here in a little bit too. So that should have been that same green, but I'm going to go ahead and keep on trucking along, adding a little bit of adhesive to the back side of these and popping them in. All right. So this one's going to be the same thing. I'm going to go ahead and get my letters in there. And then I'll glue them down just so I can kind of get them about where I want them to be. There we go. And then we're going to get our next few pieces in here. I'm loving the way that this is turning out. It is so, so cute. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and get me a little bit more glue down here because this is the same one that we're going to be doing with that little paintbrush. So easy peasy, flipping them over and getting them on. All right, so here is our super cute sunnies. I think that came out so adorable. Love it. All right, so we're gonna set that one out of the way and keep on working. So for the next one, let's go ahead and get our flower piece here. So what I'm gonna do too, same thing, because these kind of go like this. I wanna double check that everything is lining up the way that it's supposed to. And so I'll go ahead and get and just double checking everything looks good. Once you're happy with it, same thing. Now this one is pretty easy. Once again, too, these are pretty chunky pieces, so they're a lot easier to add that glue to. There you have it. Next piece down, super duper easy, nice 3D chunk. So we'll get that out of the way. Let's go ahead and get this one. This one's gonna be super duper easy. So this one's just a little two part here like this. We're gonna add some adhesive. Get it down, so. Here we have it. So cute. I love it. Nice. Going to set that out of the way. So now let's go ahead. Before we actually work on that one, let's do this one. It's going to be pretty easy too. So this is our little, our life support. What do you call that? Little life ring, if you will. So we're going to go ahead and get this one down like. To keep it nice and centered because we do still have, I'm going to double check that I'm putting this the way that it's supposed to. Let me make sure. For a sec, I'm going to have adhesive everywhere. All right, there we go. I think that's going to be okay. All right, so we're going to get that piece down. And then these little bitty blue pieces are going to come over here. So we're going to use our paintbrush again. And we're going to add a little bit of adhesive to the backside. So as you guys could see here, there was a lot of pieces, but this is, I mean, it's a ton of fun to put it together. You can really see though, I mean, it doesn't take a whole long time to do this project. So even if you're just doing these for fun, if you love to put together puzzles and things like that, you would love projects like this. I just think they're a ton of fun. And like I said, it just helps to kind of organize everything. So as I'm taking it off, I'm organizing it on my little cart there, a little cookie tray if you want to. Get yourself some cookie sheets and organize all of your pieces. So there is our little life raft, if you will. Life raft, life ring. You know what I'm talking about. All right, so here we go. So let's go into, I'm trying to save that one. It's got a little bit more letters. Let's do our sign really quick. So this is going to be fun. Because I love the fact that it has its own, we're able to create our own little sign here with these little pieces here. I think this is so cool. And it's going to create this 3D like wooden sign, if you will. So we're just going to be able to glue those on just like so. So we're going to go ahead. I'm going to start with this one here, right up here at the top. And as we're gluing these down, because obviously this glue is going to take just a second, I'm going to be able to shift everything around to make sure everything is right where it needs to be. So we'll be able to kind of play around with this here in a sec if anything needs to be shifted. All right, go ahead and get our next one here. Bring in our last one. So as you can see how easy that was to make your very own sign. Can you imagine doing these? Because you can make signs like this as well that are bigger. So say for example, if I just wanted to size this out and make a fun summer sign for my table, I could literally just use this and make a really fun 3D sign using my Glowforge. All right, so now I'm just kind of shifting everything around, making sure it's where it needs to be. So I'm happy with this. All right, so now what we're going to do is we're going to start adding everything in. So once again, I'll play around with my pieces before I glue them because we're working with the letters again. So I'm going to go ahead and get Summer up here first. Let's go ahead and do that now. So we get our word Summer. Stuck together. They're supposed to be separate. And then we are going to have the vibes where it went. Here we go. Down here. And then we are going to be bringing in our little drink glass here. We're going to have this piece in here. This is going to be a 3D. So you see we painted the whole piece there. That's going to go right there. We'll have our two little leaves come in here in a second. Oop, like that. And then we're going to have that straw. So I'm just trying to make sure where my straw lands compared to my summer words as well, just to see how high I need those to go. All right, so I think we're almost there with this. Get that straw right here. Now I've got to pay attention when I get this straw down. I may have to do some maneuvering with some tweezers. Let me grab my tweezers. I may have to take some tweezers here when I go to glue this down to get that maneuver. Because when it comes to this straw, you really want to make it realistic. So we want to keep those two pieces lined up together. I believe that was all of those pieces that belong in this one. So let's go ahead and start gluing them down. So start with the word summer. We're going to do that same thing with just applying it with the paintbrush. Since they're smaller pieces. So once again, I'm going to go ahead and speed it up. And there you guys have it. So now we have our little frame. You guys can see that one there with its little 3D effect. Now you may want to go over, once you're done with this, you may want to go back with your edges and really clean those up and have them all, you know, one duke over it with black or white or whatever you want to do to clean that up. But there is our next one. I think it's so cute. All right, so let's go ahead and go into our last layer piece. So we're going to go ahead and come in with this piece first. All right. So we have these little pieces that are going to go like this, and then that one. And that's where we're going to start with this thing. So I think I can go ahead and do this. Dabble that on just like so. And then we'll do the same. Go ahead and get this here. Get that down. And then we'll go ahead and get our last piece here. All right. There we have it. Looks good. All right, so next, let's go ahead and get our little palm trees up here at the very top. So I'm going to go ahead and use our paintbrush. I'm going to go ahead and just get these guys right up here. And top of this one kind of broke off here. It should all be connected, but mine, I just now snapped it. So I'm going to pop that right there. I'm going to save this for just a minute. So I'm going to do the same thing. So it's like, I'm going to put the best. Now this has like a little offset too. So you can kind of see where those letters are going to go on the ends there. And then we're going to have the word ever right here. Now, this is where it does help up. It does help to have that score line. So, for example, where I got off on summer and things like that, the score lines are going to just help line these up so much better. But if you're wanting to save a little bit of time and you don't really want the score lines, you don't mind trying to line everything up, you could do without. All right, so just like that, and then this little piece is going to go here like so. So let's go ahead and keep on going. So I think I can go ahead and swipe some blue across here. All right, so working on our very last one here. I'm going to go ahead and get the S down first. All right, and then I'm going to go back and get my R down. I'm going to work from side to side, so hopefully I could keep this where I want it to be. So you just work however makes life easy for you. Now, once again, it would be really easy if you took a piece of tape across the top of this. I'll definitely be trying that very soon so I can show you guys what I'm talking about. And then, you know, get the adhesive down and then pop it back down. So that's something else you can do too. So I'm sure there is tons of little hacks out there, but having those score lines is going to make your life a dream. So I do highly recommend using those score lines that are available for you. All right, so we're just going to go ahead and pop those down, and look how super cute that is. That came out so cute, a very nice 3D effect. We forgot to glue down one piece. And when I say we, I mean me. So I'm going to go ahead and get down our very last piece right here. Okay. There we have it. So cute. I love it. All right. So we've got all of our pieces here. So let me go and get a string. We're going to run it through here and we're going to put together our tray. All right. So now that we've got all of our fun pieces painted, we are ready to go. We've got our little tray here. We're just going to organize. So with ones like this that have your little hole here, those are for you to string across. You're just going to get yourself a little piece of yarn or string. And you just simply want to feed those through. So that's what I'm doing now. So this is really nice. It's just going to make a little cute thing that you can hang off the top or wherever, however you want to. So I'm just going to feed through. We've only got two more pieces to go. So then you have your little streamer of these little guys. So we are going to, once I get these up here, I can kind of have them, you know, kind of hanging over right about here. I'll get those held down somehow. I can kind of get some tape or something like that. I'll get it in just a bit. So I'm going to kind of hold that one for the end there. So I've got those tied on. So let's go ahead and start putting our pieces on our tray. All right, now it's just a part of having fun with it. So you can put these pieces wherever, however you want to. So something like this, I may want to have it as my top piece. So I may want to turn this to where it's going to kind of prop on here somewhere about like that. So like I said, just feel free to play around with these pieces of where they're going to fit. I'm kind of curious. If I couldn't get this little fun guy in here like so, maybe even on the edge like that. Hopefully you guys can see everything. And then I'm going to kind of get this guy right down here at the bottom like so. Hopefully you guys can see that. And then we can do the same. I'm hoping, let's see, I should have got a little bit of a taller, one. So I might be able to do something about like that. And then I'm trying to see here, get my little rings in here. May want to scoot this guy. Try to see. Maybe even something fun like this. So you feel free to kind of tilt these in here however they're going to fit. And so like something like this, I'm trying to decide on, where did it go? It's got that greenery. I think I'm going to try to fit, you know, some little greenery in here. But once again, if you had some little beads or something like that, you can definitely do that. So I'm just going to go ahead and keep popping these guys in here just like so. So I think we've got room for this little guy. I'm trying to make sure. Hopefully you guys can see everything. And there you guys have it, this super cute tier tray project for this summer. Now, like I said, mine is a 3-tier tray. You could definitely use a 2-tiered metal tray. There's ceramic ones. There is all sorts of different ones. You can even make your own trays with your Glowforge. So we have this file linked down below for you guys. So everything I've used today, all of the supplies, everything can be found in the description below, as well as even the paint. the wood glue. It's all down there. So definitely make sure you guys are checking out that description. But this is an amazing file. Like I said, whether you guys are making these for yourself, for a friend, family member, if you will, or you're selling them, say, for example, even in your boutique or online or whatever, this is a super, super fun one. And I hope you guys are going to try it out. Now, if you guys do recreate this, we want to see your projects. Use hashtag design bundles so we can check it out. You can also join our Facebook community group if you're not already and come hang out with us. We have hundreds of thousands of other members over there hanging out, crafting, creating. You're going to get lots of inspiration. You're going to find deals over there. And if you guys have a question, for example, we're going to get to you right away. So definitely make sure you check that out. We have it in the description below. And also, if you guys are not subscribed, I would encourage you to do so. We do things like this with the Glowforge, Cricut, Silhouette, Sublimation, all sorts of fun things. We even go live every single Monday at 2 p.m. Central Standard Time. And then you can also catch us on the live during our Design Bundles Dollar Deal. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. And if you guys did, please hit the like button down below and subscribe. And we'll see you guys on the next one. Bye for now.